Hey, do you want to try Node-RED, but you haven't got a fancy install of Home Assistant, such as Hasbian or has.io? Well, in this video, I'm not only going to show you the best and easiest ways to install it on your system, but also how to make sure it stays running, regardless of updates and reboots. As a bonus, I'm going to show you where to find modules or plugins, add-ons, whatever you want to call them, that you may need while running Node-RED with Home Assistant, and also how to find modules that you need, but I don't mention. Coming up after the intro. Right, so just a note, I'm not going to be covering installations on Raspberry Pis, mainly because if you've got a Raspberry Pi, then you're probably using Hasbian or has.io, and has.io as the add-on store. See my previous video, I'll link to it in the card above. And Hasbian I've not covered yet. However, I am going to say that it might be just as easy to go into your package manager, do a search for node-red or node-red one word, play with variants. If you can find it in your package manager, then that is a big bonus and a lot easier than the way that I'm going to show you. So just do it that way. Right, so step one. The first thing that we need to do is we need to make sure that we have Node.js installed. Right, so if you're running any of these systems, then you will be glad to know that your package manager has got Node.js already covered. You can install it through that, and even in Windows, installing Node.js is easy to do. What I'll do is I will link in the description below for any of you that are having trouble with finding it in your package manager, things like that. And it links to a page on the Node.js site that basically runs through each of the systems and gives you a bit more detail on how to accomplish that task. Step two is version numbers. Right, so assuming you now have Node.js installed, you need to make sure that you've got the right version installed. Hopefully you've just installed it via a package manager and it's all done, latest version. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to our command line and we're going to type node space dash v, and that will tell us what version number we have. I do believe on some versions of Ubuntu, I know when I was using Ubuntu to work with a few years back, I had a bit of trouble with it, and it turns out that it wasn't Node, it was Node.js, one word, no dot. So either Node-V or Node.js, one word, obviously without the one word, dash V, and that will return your version number. Right, so if it returns 0.10 or 0.12, they are ancient, get rid of them. If you are using version 4 or version 6, those versions are fine. However, you do need to make sure that you have any bug patches, security updates, things like that installed. Now, Node-RED recommends a minimum version of LTS 8, which is long-term support. And that means that if you install version 8 with it being a long-term support, it's going to be well catered for. Now, at the time of this recording, I'm running the latest version, which is version 9.10.1. Again, anything 4 plus is fine, just as long as you've got the latest updates and things like that installed. Right, so now we've got Node.js installed and we've got the correct version installed, we can move on to step number 3, which is installing Node-RED. The recommended way to install it is with npm. Now you can check whether you've got npm by typing which space npm, and if it comes up with a file path, then you're all set to go. If not, then just do a search for npm in your package manager and it will be there. Okay, right, so the command that we're going to use to install Node-RED is sudo space npm space install space dash v space --unsafe-perm --node-red. Right, for Windows users, you are okay. You can still install Node-RED as long as you have Windows 7 upwards. And you need to go into the command prompt or PowerShell. The Node-RED people recommend using the PowerShell because it is more like Linux. So the command that you're typing in is npm install -g --unsafe-perm --node-red. Awesome. Step four. So now we can run Node-RED. So to start Node-RED, just type node-red into your terminal. And it started. Right, now we move on to the slightly tricky bit, step five, which is making sure that Node-RED starts up when your computer starts up. Let's move on to step six, which is the modules, the plugins, the add-ons. If you haven't already, go to your browser. Right, if you go into the burger menu in the top right-hand corner, you will see a pull-out menu and you want to click on Manage Palettes. Okay, once you've clicked on that, your initial view is palettes or add-ons that you already have installed. If you click on the Install tab and you click where it says Search Modules, this is where we need to type in the modules that we're looking for. So because this is a Home Assistant video, if we type in Home-Assistant, you will see that we get three entries. We are bothered about the two that say Home Assistant in the title and not the has one. So if you're using WebSockets, then use the one with -ws on the end. If you're not, use the one without -ws on the end. Click on Install and it will give you a bit of a warning. It will basically just tell you that there is information available for this module. Now I recommend that you click on the Open Node Information button. Have a quick read of that. If that is the module that you're looking for, then by all means click Install and it will install. It will come up with a box that says Node X or Node Y has been added to your palette, and you can then look in the left hand side or wherever you have your node list, and if it does install nodes that you can play around with, then you will see it there somewhere. Now that I've explained how to do that, some of the ones that I think people may be interested in, I haven't got any facts or figures to back this up, it's just a swag. Okay, so if you use ift, if this then that, then there's a plugin for that. If you use Amazon Alexa, there are several plugins for that. If you use Android and you use Join, the Tasker plugin, then there is a module for that. And that's quite good. That will allow you to send Tasker commands or receive Tasker commands, things like that. So that, I think that's quite good. And if you have your browser window open quite a bit, then you may be interested in the Play Audio module. And what that will do is, if you follow a flow through and then you pass something to a function, it can be the result of a variable or just a hard-coded message. You pass it on to Play Audio and it will send off to Google text-to-speech, and it will read it out for you in the language of your choice, assuming it's supported. And the last one that I'm going to mention is Sonoff. There are a few Sonoff ones. There is Sonoff and Sonoff Tasmota. They're both pretty much the same. So read the node information page. Takes your pick. Right, so if you found this video useful, then give it a big thumbs up. If you want to see when I post some more videos, which will be pretty soon, hopefully, fingers crossed, then click on that subscribe button, click on the notification bell, and that will let you know when my new videos are posted. So if you want a tour of my Node-RED installation and a brief outline on how I use it, then click there. If you want to see a different video from my collection, click there. That's it. Thank you. Bye-bye.